Hello and welcome to One Life Investment. This is Mihir Praswell and welcome to the first video of our video series called Get Based. So make sure you subscribe for more base related content and follow on Twitter at One Life Investment so that you don't miss out on our future uploads. If you're not familiar with what Base is, it's a layer 2 blockchain built by Coinbase and it's actually built on Optimism stack in a similar way to other EVM layer 2 you might have used in the past. For example, your Arbitrum, IMX, Starknet, Ronin, etc. In this first video, we will learn how to add the Base network to EVM wallet. Depending on the wallet you might have, some wallets support the Base network out of the box and are compatible with them. So if you interact with any dApp that is on the Base network, you might be able to add them automatically. In this guide though, I'll go over a couple of different ways to do so and should apply for any wallet you're using as long as they're EVM compatible. If you don't know what EVM compatible is, so the likes of your MetaMask, Trust Wallet, Rabi Wallet, all of those wallets are EVM compatible. And for other resources that I deem will be helpful for you, they will be in the description below. So let's get started. One of my personal go-to websites to add network is Chainlist, and it is EVM compatible networks and it lists almost all of the EVM compatible networks. So this protects you from any downside or any risk that you might have by connecting to any website that's not trustworthy and your wallet might be compromised. So make sure you are not connecting your wallet to any random website that you see. So chainlist.org is quite safe and has a good reputation. So go to chainlist.org or the link in the description. Connect your wallet. For this tutorial, I'm using MetaMask, so I'm going to go next and click connect. And I'm going to search for Base. I'm going to click on MetaMask and I will double check to see if it's correct. And I'll go approve and switch network. All right, so if I go to my MetaMask, got it, close that. And as you can see, it says connecting to Base Llama nodes. And now if you click on the network, as you can see, I'm connected to Base Llama node. So now depending on the network you have, now if you are a bit more advanced user, what you can do is you can change the RPC server address. An RPC server is basically a server address for your wallet to connect to for transacting over the Base network. You have a choice on which RPC servers you'd like to use, or you can just go with whatever the chain list has. So that's the first way to add the Base network. So if you don't want to do this, then if you are using MetaMask, what you can do is you can add the network directly from within MetaMask. So for example, if I open the MetaMask wallet or MetaMask wallet extension, and if I go add a network, and if you scroll down, you should see Base Mainnet. And you will see this warning, but that's fine. Click on add. As you can see, it's a different network URL as opposed to your Llama nodes. It doesn't really matter. It's just a different RPC endpoint. And click on approve. And you can click on switch to Base Mainnet. And as you can see, you are connected to the Base. Now, there's one more way to do it, and which is probably a lot easier depending on what you're connecting to. But the only thing you got to make sure is you are connecting to a reputable dApp or decentralized application. My go-to is usually Uniswap. So for example, let's say that I have a wallet which doesn't have a Base network and it doesn't have out-of-box support for Base network. So what I normally do is, as long as that network is supported by Uniswap, I just go use Uniswap. For in this example, Base Uniswap and Base, they support each other. So I'm going to go uniswap.org. Always make sure that you know the correct URL you're visiting, because there are a lot of pretend websites that will actually phish you. Click on launch app. And on top right corner, it's by default connected to Ethereum layer 1. Click on the drop down menu and click on Base. And what's going to happen is, if your wallet doesn't have the network called Base network, it's going to give you a prompt to approve. As you can see, just make sure that you are getting the correct prompt and the network URL, chain ID and the name is correct, and you're not getting a fake prompt. Click on approve, switch network, and there you have it. So now your wallet is connected to Base. And then you can carry out transactions on the Base network, similar to your Ethereum L1 or any other network that you are connected to. Now that's how you add the Base network to your wallet and carry out transactions or use the dApps, decentralized applications on the Base network. Make sure you leave any suggestions, or if you have a particular request for Base network or any other topics or any other blockchains or any other projects, make sure you leave them in the comments below and make sure you subscribe for future guides as well. Thank you and you have a nice day.